Welcome to the last episode of the series. We hope you enjoyed the series so far and now have a good understanding of Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server, its many exciting features, how to monitor, tune performance, save costs, and how to develop applications with MySQL Flexible Server. Before we close out, I wanted to share some of the important resources with you again and leave you with a call to action. I would urge you to go through our homepage and documentation at aka.ms/mysqldocs to do a quick recap and also to get detailed information on all the features and functionalities we discussed in the series so far. But to get comfortable with the service, I would suggest that you should actually try it out. Go check out our Azure free account and do a quick POC to get a first-hand experience of the product. Meanwhile, you can look at our Azure pricing calculator to understand the financial aspects involved. And finally, refer to our migration guide to get started and move your workloads onto Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server. Stay tuned for latest updates and announcements from us. We have a lot of exciting features, resources, and campaigns planned for you. You can keep an eye out on the What's New page, our tech community blog, and also follow us on social media. If you want to write to us directly to share feedback or suggestions, you can use the email ID mentioned here and share your feedbacks on Azure Feedback Portal as well. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the series or if you want us to do some more on top of it, just let us know in the comment section below. Thank you again, and I hope you have a great day ahead.